In this quick Premiere Pro tutorial, I'll show you how to close all gaps in the timeline with just one click. Typically, if you want to remove gaps between clips in Premiere Pro, you'll use the Ripple Delete function. Right-click in the space between any two clips and select Ripple Delete, or just left-click in a space and hit the Delete key on your keyboard. And this will delete the gap and automatically shift all subsequent clips to the left. But if you have a lot of gaps in your timeline, and you want to get rid of them all at once, rather than manually deleting them one by one, just go up to Sequence and click Close Gap. If you want to remove all gaps between a specific section of your sequence, select only the range of clips you want to clean up and click Close Gap. Or you can set in and out points for the area you want to modify by hitting I and O on the keyboard, and then, you guessed it, Close Gap. Now, if you're finishing up a project and you want to make sure you haven't left any gaps in your timeline, or if you have a really complicated sequence with lots of tracks and clips, which this is not, but if it was, you can quickly find the next gap in your timeline by going to Sequence, go to Gap, Next in Sequence. You can also use the keyboard shortcut for that, which is Shift Semicolon. And you can find the previous gap in your sequence by going to Sequence, go to Gap, Previous in Sequence. Or hitting Option Semicolon on a Mac, or Control Shift Semicolon if you're working on a PC. There's one small gotcha here. This will only find instances where there's a gap in all video and audio tracks on the timeline. If I try to go to the next gap in this sequence, for example, nothing happens. That's because while there are a number of gaps between clips on different tracks here, there are no complete gaps anywhere in the sequence. So if you want to fine-tune your selection, you need to turn on track targeting for the tracks you want to scan for gaps. Select a track, then go to Sequence, go to Gap, and Next or Previous in Track. I'll select Next in Track here, and Premiere Pro will find the next gap on that track, but ignore the gaps on any other tracks. If I target multiple tracks and select Next in Track, Premiere Pro will go to the next gap it finds in any of those tracks. If you found this Adobe Premiere Pro tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave a nice comment.